Hi friends, this is Kruti Jaipancholi, Assistant Professor in LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. This video is about subject Microwave Engineering. So friends, in the last video, you learn about the various modern trends in the microwave engineering. Now in this video, we are going to learn about other microwave trends, that is the MMIC. Now as we know that, it's a new microwave technology. Due to the tremendous demand in the miniature of the technology, the MMIC demand that is more. And that is why the use of this all the MMIC that is in the radar, in the commercial fields that has been done. So, the MMIC, full form of that is the Monolithic Microwave Integrated Circuits, is a new microwave technology. It is used in the radar, electronic warfare and the various commercial field. Now, what is the advantage of using this MMIC? Due to the use of the MMIC, the size of the electronic circuit that has reduced, as well as the circuits that are become cheaper. So now, due to that, the MMIC use, okay, that could be the commercial now. There are three types of the circuit element that either are used in the chip form or they are fabricated in the MIC. That are the distributed transmission line, microstrip, strip, etc. Other is the using the lumped element R, L and C. And the solid state devices that are the FETs, BJTs, diodes, okay. So this kind of the elements that can be used. There are two type of the MICs that are hybrid microwave integrated circuits, that is the HMICs, and another one that is the monolithic microwave integrated circuits, that is the MMIC. This monolithic, that is the Greek letter. The mono mean the single and lithos mean the stone. Okay, so this monolithic integrated circuit that is built on a single crystal. This MMICs or monolithic microwave integrated circuits, okay, are a type of the integrated circuits, IC, and that are operate onto the microwave frequency, that is from the 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. Okay, so using this the MMIC, it can perform the functions such as the microwave mixing, power amplification, low noise amplification and high frequency switching. Okay, this MMIC, the dimensions are around the 1 millimeter square to 10 millimeter square. Okay, and it can be the mass produced and allow the purification of the high frequency devices such as the cellular phones. Okay, due to this, the use of this, that is again the easier, okay, and it does not require the any external matching network. Now the structure of the monolithic MMIC, you can see over here, it is what? You can see that the structure, okay, that is like the you have seen the printed circuit board, okay, so it can comes into that form also. So you can see that all the components, okay, they are made over here, okay, as the small components, okay, and they are also the microwave strip line components, okay. So these all, this is the structure of the monolithic IC. This is the MMIC, okay. You can see that the how the different elements that is designed over here, that how, what is the shape of that inductor, how it is designed, okay, then the capacitor, so all the lumped elements, okay, they can design, okay, in terms of the microwave element, and this way the micro MMIC component look life. Okay. Similarly, what are the materials that can be used for the monolithic microwave integrated circuit? So, the substrate materials are the aluminium, beryllium, ferrite, GaAs, glass, okay. So, these all are the material that can be chosen as a substrate material. There are the properties, the characteristics of ideal substrate material and that can be used for the fabrication of the MMIC. That are the higher dielectric constant that is required, low power dissipation factor, then after the dielectric constant should remain constant over the frequency range of the interest, okay, high purity and constant thickness, high surface smoothness, high resistivity and electric strength, as well as the high thermal conductivity. So these all are the characteristics of the substrate material. Now the other thing that is for the conducting purpose, the conducting layers, okay, in the normal IC over here, it's a conducting material. So it is the aluminium, copper, gold, silver, okay. So these all are the materials that can be used as the conducting material. The conducting material that have the following characteristics, that are the conducting material that should have the high conductivity, okay, low temperature coefficient of the resistance, good adhesion to the substrate, good etchability and the solderability, easily deposited, okay. So these all are the characteristics of the conducting material used for the MMIC fabrication. Then after the dielectric material, so dielectric material, okay, that are the SiO, okay, silicon, silicon dioxide, okay, aluminium, okay. So these all are the materials that can be used. The characteristics of all these materials that is used as a dielectric materials, that are the reproducibility, the capacity of the withstanding high voltage, ability to undergo process without developing the pinholes, and the low RF dielectric circuit loss. Okay, so this is about the material. Now the resistive material, the resistive films, okay, that is used, okay, to make the MMIC. So that the resistive materials, they are used in the MMIC, that is for the bias network, terminators and the attenuators. It should have the good stability, low temperature coefficient of the resistance, adequate dissipation capability and the sheet resistives, the range of the 10 to 100 ohm per square. Okay, so this way the materials that are used for the MMIC fabrications as we have seen. Now there are the various advantages of the MMIC. So you have seen that how to compact the circuit using the MMIC. So we can say that the advantages, that is the small size, then the lighter weight, okay, mass production that can be possible, so cost of that circuit that can be also reduced, okay, the high reliability, we can improve the reproducibility, okay, and also performance that can be also improved by using the MMIC. Okay, so disadvantage, okay, of the MMIC, that is the very small sizes, okay, so that the processing difficulties that sometimes we could found, okay, as well as the tolerance discontinuities, okay, due to the some component, okay, and trimming after the fabrication, that is also difficult, okay. So disadvantage, that is the inherent resistive losses, the small size that limits the heat dissipation. Okay, so these are the disadvantage of the MMIC. Now the application of the MMIC. Okay, so MMIC, okay, that are the suitable for the space as well as the military applications. Okay, and other application that is in the radar, okay, this MMIC that can be also used. The other areas that are the communication, homeland security scanners, and imaging and the sensors, okay. So these all are the area where the MMIC that can be used, okay. So the next topic is the RF MEMS for the microwave component. What is a MEM? The MEM means the micro electromechanical system. What is it? It's a technology that enables the batch fabrication of the miniature mechanical structure devices as well as the systems, okay. So that are the MEMS, okay, and it was developed in the year of the 1970 for the pressure and the temperature sensors, accelerometers and other sensor devices, okay. So you can see over here that this is the one example of the MEMS, okay. So the MEMS refer that's to the miniature mechatronic system. Again, it is fabricated using the VLSI technology and techniques, and the processes to design and create the miniature system, miniature embedded system, okay. So this you can see that this is the MEM, okay, and it is used in the devices. So this is the one main creation of the MEMS, you can see over here. Fine. Function of the MEMS, what are the function? So function, the security, sensing circuitry, controlling motion micro devices, radiating the motion micro devices, okay. So what it will do? It will convert the physical stimuli events and the parameters to electrical, mechanical and the optical signals, okay. So this is the one perform, okay. And another task, that is it performs the actuation, it performs the sensing and the other functions, okay. What are the benefits of the MEMS? So MEMS, okay, that are the micro size sensors and actuator. So whenever you want to integrate with the any of the electronic circuitry onto the single chip, so using this MEM it can be also possible to implement, okay, onto the single chip, okay. Decrease the cost of the production and bulk processing, okay. So many few new features and the products that can be also possible. We can have also combine of combination of the MEMS with the other branches. For example, the optical MEMS, bio-MEMS, heuristic devices. Okay, so these all are the application. So here you can see in the diagram that the how the RF MEMS that can be useful everywhere. So here in the diagram you can see that okay, wherever you will go, okay, you need a devices, okay, you need a micro devices that can be adjusted and fitted with the other devices, and we can take the advantage of that, okay. So this is the applications or the area where which the RF MEMS that can be used, okay. So as I said that okay, importance of all these MMIC fabrication, that is in the microwave imaging. So microwave imaging, that's again the best application, okay, of the microwaves. So here in the diagram you can see that a very good application of the microwave imaging, that is in the biomedical field, okay. And how the microwaves that can be used, okay, and how it can also detect the particular disease by the physical property of the tissues, okay. So the microwave imaging, that is what? So microwave signal, that we know that it can penetrate through the human body and dielectric material, that is any optically non-transparent media, okay. So this feature, okay, of the microwave signal, that is used in the microwave engineering, and it is used in the ground penetrating radar, weapon detection, imaging through wall, and the non-destructive testing for the structural reliability. Okay, so it is also used for detecting the cancer, okay, and in the diathermy also it can be useful. We can also get the information about the both the physiological state, okay, and the anatomical structure of the human tissues, okay, and the imaging with the microwave that allows the non-destructive evaluation of the biological tissues due to non-ionizing nature of the microwaves. So it changes the dielectric properties of a tissue related to the physiological condition. Okay, so that is about the microwave imaging and the best application, okay, that is frequently used application of the microwave imaging, that is in the detection of the breast cancer. Okay, so this way all the applications, okay, of the microwaves, okay, imaging. So that are microwave imaging are the two types. The microwave imaging are the passive microwave imaging system and the active microwave imaging system. Here you can see the diagram, okay, and this microwave imaging system, okay, that can be used to map, okay, sea, ice and snow, okay, and also it just gives you the idea about mapping all this thing, okay, or it won't gives you the information about the direction. Okay, so this is about the passive microwave imaging system. Now this is the last video up to the 90% syllabus of the microwave engineering. The next chapter, okay, that is about the microwave system. Now that microwave systems are the very simple thing which you learn in the other subjects like the wireless communication. You have to write the short note onto the wireless communication, short note onto the satellite communication system. You need to write down the short note onto the radar system. So everything that we have covered, okay, as well as you can also write the from the wireless communication video. So thank you very much, everyone.